Hi guys, this is Ella Rifkin and welcome to my Facebook Live. And today, if you stay with me till the end of the presentation, you will discover how to pay less taxes. You will discover how to start the journey to your financial freedom, how to save money on taxes. You will discover what is traditional IRA, what is Roth IRA, what is the difference between traditional and Roth IRA, what is 401k and the difference between regular 401k and Roth 401k. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Ella Rifkin, a financial freedom coach, an accountant with over 20 years of experience in tax planning, tax preparation, in accounting, in business, in opening and starting the businesses and in planning. And I'm an author of 2 bestseller books. And most importantly, I'm a taxpayer myself. I pay the taxes and I know how frustrated it is when you have to pay a lot and how we all want to save money and how we all want to have the financial freedom not to worry about the money and just spend for whatever that we like. So if you stay with me till the end of this presentation, then you will discover all the secrets that I'm sharing with you. I'm sharing all of this based on the real life cases, based on the tax returns that I prepare, based on the tax planning that I do with my clients. And I'm sharing all of this with you. And after my last presentation, I received many different inquiries. That's why I have put this presentation together. And that's why I'm talking about the retirement, if you can see that, about the putting money away for the retirement and about paying less taxes and saving money. So I know it's the end of the tax season, so no worries. If you haven't put away the money towards the retirement, if you haven't established any pension plans, then it's okay, no worries. That's why I'm actually talking about this, because the earlier you start, the better it is. It's okay that it's the end of the tax season, but the year just started and you still have enough time to do the tax planning, to do the strategic tax planning, to meet up with your tax planners and start actually planning before the year ends and before the new tax season starts. So let's start and begin. But before I'm gonna go into the real life cases, what I wanna do is I wanna actually talk a little bit about these pension plans, about the IRA and about the 401k. As I did receive many different inquiries of the difference between the traditional IRA and the Roth IRA, then the what is 401k. And so that's why I wanna talk a little bit about this first, and then we'll go back to the real case scenarios where I will show in real life cases how you actually save in money and how you benefit from it. So let's just start with the what is the traditional IRA. The traditional IRA as well as the Roth IRA are the individual retirement accounts. So this is what allowed by the IRS for the individual is to open up a traditional IRA, or you can choose to do Roth IRA, individual account, where you can put a maximum for this year, 2019, you can put a maximum of $6,000. So you can put a maximum of $6,000 into that individual retirement account. And the same applies for the Roth IRA. If you are over age 15, then you can make an additional $1,000 catch up contribution. It's an additional $1,000. These accounts can be opened up anywhere at any financial institution. This is just an account that you're opening, but then of course you need to do something with this money. So what you can do is that you can just leave it on the CD, on the money market account. However, you might not accumulate a lot of interest. Or what you can do if you want to go a little bit more aggressive, then you can invest it into the mutual funds. You will go and open a brokerage account, and then they will invest into the mutual funds or even stocks. I'm not an investor. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just letting you know how it's usually done. So the next step is, if you do have that retirement account, then the benefit actually of traditional account, traditional IRA, it's tax deductible money. So what does it mean? If you put away the $6,000 into that account, then you're deducting it from your taxable income, from your gross income, and then you're not paying any tax on this $6,000. On the contrary, the Roth IRA, the $6,000 that you will be contributing, you will have to pay the tax. The next difference is the traditional IRA is the deferred income. So all the money that you put in there, so you put the $6,000 into the account. And let's say in a year, you earned an interest of $1,000. So the $1,000 that you earned, the interest that you accumulated, is tax deferred. You don't have to pay any taxes, and then that just continues on and on. So if for the first year you made $1,000, the next year you earned another $1,000, and then after that another. So all the money that you earn in there, they completely tax deferred, and you do not pay any taxes. And then with the traditional IRA, the fourth is you pay taxes only on the amount that you withdraw. So let's say the same instance. So you put away the $6,000, and then over the 5 years, you earned $6,000 in there. So now you have $12,000. And let's assume that you're already at the retirement age, you're over age 59 and a half. And out of this $12,000, you would like to withdraw $1,000. So you're only gonna pay tax on that $1,000 that you're taking out. Not on the whole 12, but only on the $1,000 that you're taking out. And in the traditional IRA, if you take the money out before the retirement age, which is 59 and a half, then there is a 10% penalty. So now let's go to the Roth IRA and then see the difference. So you can contribute the same amounts as we mentioned. On the other hand, it's not tax deductible. So meaning if you put away the $6,000, then you first have to pay tax on them. So you pay the tax and then you put them away into that account. All the money that you earn in there, the interest, the dividends, the capital gains, or whatever it is that you're making, they are completely tax-free money. It's not just tax deferred as with the traditional IRA. It's tax free. So what do I mean by that? So let's say that you have the same $6,000 that you put in there as we did in this example. So let's just say pay taxes. Okay, we'll do it like that. So here the example was that you put away $6,000. You earned $6,000 interest. So we'll just make an example of that. So that came out that there was $12,000 in the account and you decided to take $1,000 as a withdrawal. So on that $1,000, you will have to pay the tax. So whatever tax bracket you are currently in, you will pay the tax on this $1,000. And I did actually put a case study together for you just to show more in the details. So on the contrary, with this one, let's assume the same numbers. So you put away the same $6,000 and then you made the $6,000 interest. So we still have the same $12,000. This is the interest that you earn. And then you decided to take the $1,000 out as the withdrawal. So on that $1,000 that you're taking out, there is completely zero tax. The remarkable thing about the Roth IRA is if you, and you can see this in the difference, if you take the money once you are at the retirement age already at 59 and a half. If you decide to take the whole $12,000, then there is zero tax on this whole $12,000. Why? Because you already paid the tax on the $6,000 that you made the contribution for. And the regulations of that Roth IRA is whatever money that you earn, whatever money that you make throughout all this time, they completely tax-free. So if you take the whole $12,000, then there's zero tax. Isn't this unbelievable? So this is how you can make the money and not pay any taxes at all. Another benefit of the Roth IRA is there is no penalty. So if you do decide to take the money before you age 59 and a half, in a traditional IRA, as you can see, you pay 10% penalty. In a Roth IRA, if you take the contribution withdrawal before age 59 and a half, then there is no penalty. What do I mean by that? So if you contributed the $6,000 and then you kept them at least for 5 years in that account, and then after 5 years you have $12,000, let's just use these numbers, you're not 59 and a half yet, but you decided to take the whole $6,000 that you contributed. You can absolutely do this and there will be no penalty and no tax impact on that. So this is the difference between the traditional IRA and between the Roth IRA. So why then, you might ask me the question, and a lot of people actually, a lot of my clients do ask the question. So then why would I contribute to traditional IRA if I can take the money completely tax-free, if I can take the money out before age 59 and a half? On the other hand, you might ask the same question, why would you contribute to Roth IRA if you're not having any tax deductions right now, if you're not benefiting about in your money right now? So there is differences, and that's why I have put these two presentations for you together that I will show you. It's all about tax planning. It's all about strategic planning. It's all about how you plan. Ideally, is as I mentioned last time in my presentation, ideally is to use all of these vehicles. Ideally is to take advantage of all of it, to take advantage of the traditional IRA or traditional 401k. By the way, the 401k plan, traditional and Roth 401k, they do work the same way. It's just with the 401k, the biggest benefit versus the traditional IRA is that you can make a higher contribution. This year for 2019, you can make, last year was $18,500. So that was the maximum that you could make the contribution with the catch-up contribution. So total was $24,500. But this year it was increased, so you can actually make a $19,000, again with the same catch-up of $6,000, which is total of $25,000. So the 401k gives you availability to contribute more of your money. However, not everybody has the availability of that because these are employer-sponsored plans. And if you do have availability, this is where I advise is to take advantage of all of it. And financially, if you can afford, then it's better to take advantage of the 401k, of the Roth IRA or traditional IRA, and then there's other many different plans. So it's very advisable to discuss with your tax planners, discuss everything in advance to see which one will you benefit from. And let me just go more into the details just to show you the benefits of the regular traditional IRA or 401k. In this case, we'll just talk about 401k, but it will be the same benefit for traditional IRA. And then another case that I have put together, that's about the Roth IRA. So let me just tell you a little bit about this case. And if any of you have questions, then please write them. Thank you all so much for participating. Thank you all so much for all the questions. I had many different inquiries. There was messages and even phone calls. So I will, as you see, I'm trying to answer everything, to address all the questions. If I wouldn't have time to cover them in our session today, then I will absolutely message you, text you, or write all the comments, or I will put another presentation to talk about it. All right, so then let's start with this case study. So this is I'm giving to you the 2017. So this is a lady. The 2017, she was 64 years old. She was pre-retirement age, and then this year in 2018, when she in 2019, when she came to do 2018, she didn't work already. So she's single, there's no dependents. Her salary in 2017 was as a W-2, 140,000. So she took advantage of the traditional 401k account, where she made a contribution of 24,000. So what it gave her is, it gave her a deduction, since it's a deductible contribution. And because of that, the benefit that she had is that she had her taxable income of 116,000. So this is the income that she was supposed to pay tax on. So because of that, before she made the contribution, just for you to see the illustration, that her tax was $25,580. After she made the 24,000 contribution towards her traditional 401k account, she only paid taxes of $18,860. So her saving was, by putting away 24,000 here, her saving was $6,720. So this was her immediate saving in 2017. So this is her second benefit, is she had more money, more cash in her pocket. So the third benefit is that she put the 24,000 away, and then she deferred the income or the interest, whatever that she earned on that account. And another benefit is that she used the tax planning, because she came to me, and then we came up with the strategy to lower her income, to pay the less taxes, and to have the tax saving, immediate tax saving benefit of $6,720. And by the way, that year she was in the 28% tax bracket. So she saved 28% on the 24,000 that she put away. So now, 2018, she retired. And this is why it's important to plan in advance. And you'll see in this illustration one. So in 2018, she retired. She didn't work anymore. So her income was zero. And I'm giving you two, three different illustrations. Then she started collecting her Social Security income, the pension benefits. Her Social Security for that year was 25,000. She, if in the first option, if she wouldn't come to me, then she wouldn't make any IRA withdrawal, because she had some other savings. She didn't need to withdraw anything, since she had her 25,000 from the Social Security. That was enough for her to live on. So if she wouldn't come to me, this would have been the way she would prepare her tax return, and her tax for the year would be zero. Now, if she comes to me, we have two options to start taking, because she made all these contributions, and this is not just in 2017 that she put the 24,000 away towards her 401k. All the prior years, she was using the same strategies. She was putting the 24,000, the maximum allowable, to save up immediate cash to have to herself. So she accumulated, it's around 300,000 that over all the last years that she accumulated in her account. So let's just put this here. So her 401k account, so let's say it's 300,000. So at some point she needs to start taking the money. And the great benefit is that you to start taking the money, not to pay any taxes and to pay the taxes less. If she takes the whole 300,000 right away, then she will have to pay the taxes and on the whole 300,000, it's gonna be very high amount. Why? Because it's gonna take you to the highest tax bracket. So then the strategy of this is to try to take them in a little amounts, not to pay any taxes at all or to pay less taxes. And this is what I'm showing to you here. So if taking into consideration her 25,000 that she received from Social Security, if she takes 13,600 as a distribution from her 401k, her tax liability still will be zero. So look at the benefit. So she put away the 13,600 and she saved 28% on that. Now she takes the 13,600 and this is completely tax-free. She doesn't have to pay any taxes absolutely at all. Or if she wants to take a little bit more and let's say pay a little bit of the taxes. Let's say for this illustration, I'm putting the, showing that she decides to take $25,000. So on that $25,000, she will only pay $2,550, which is only 10%, which is still great because she saved, if you remember here, 28%, and now she's only paying 10%. So she's still getting the benefit. So every case, every scenario is different. For this illustration, I only show to you that she only has an income of 25,000 from the Social Security. She has no other deductions. However, if you do have other deductions, if you have like a mortgage that you're paying or real estate tax or any other deductions, so you have dependents, then you can withdraw, start withdrawing even more because you have other deductions to overcompensate the amount that you're withdrawing. So it's very advisable to plan ahead, to calculate all these numbers, to create all these strategies and to see how you can start taking all this money and not to pay any taxes at all. So in this case, you can see actually that for her, it was much beneficial to make the traditional 401k contribution and to get the immediate benefits from the tax deductions. If she would have done it as a Roth IRA Roth 401k contribution, then she will actually pay the 28% taxes. She is already at the retirement age. And she needs to start taking the money right away. The chances that it's gonna accumulate and make a lot of interest are not very high. So she will absolutely not benefit from using the Roth contribution. So for her case, it was much beneficial to save the money right away. And by the way, this was only the federal saving and she does live in the New York State. For this illustration purposes, I didn't use the state examples, the state tax amounts. However, like I live in New York and she lives in New York as well. New York is one of the states that does have high taxes. We have to pay New York state taxes, New York City taxes. So in her case, besides the $6,720 that she saved with the IRS, she also saved like around $3,000 with the state as well. So these are all immediate tax savings. And in her case, it's very beneficial to have them right away. So now I have another illustration that I have put together for you for the, this is for the Roth IRA. So this is the case where the Roth is more beneficial versus the traditional IRA or traditional 401k contribution. So let's take in this scenario, in this illustration, I'm taking a family. It's a family, so it's married, filing jointly. They have two kids. and the household income is 80,000. As you can also see, I'm always using different illustrations with different amounts. There was one of the messages, one of the comments that I heard that I was talking about like high income individuals, but I am, as you can see, using different incomes. So you can see that it doesn't matter how much you make. It doesn't matter what your income, if it's 40,000, 80,000, 140, or 200. And last time I used the law numbers as well. So it doesn't matter how much you make. What matters is how you plan. What matters is how you save. And then what are you doing with all this money? So even if you're making low money, there's still a lot that you can do to plan, to save, and to create that financial freedom. As remember, the financial freedom is all in your hands, and it's all about planning in advance. It's all about how you plan and what you do with your money. So in this illustration, this household income for husband and wife, and they have two kids, is $80,000. And they don't have any write-offs to deduct. They don't own any house, and they don't pay any real estate taxes or the mortgage interest. So the total after what was allowable for them with the standard deduction and the child tax credit for two kids. The kids do go to the daycare, so they got a credit for that as well. So the total tax liability for 2018 was $4,474. And they pretty, it's a young family. They have small kids, so they're just starting up. So if they make, they're not contributing anything towards the 401k, but they decided to make an IRA contribution. So the choice was to make a traditional IRA contribution or to make a Roth IRA contribution. So in that case, if they do take advantage of the Roth IRA contribution, what will happen? They can put away $5,500 each. So that's a total amount of $11,000 for the year. And if they do that, they're not gonna get any tax deduction. They will in fact pay the taxes on that, but they already paid it through the salary. And they are in the 12% tax bracket. So they only paid on this $11,000, $1,320. Or let's say if they would have done the traditional IRA, then they would have deducted the $11,000 from the $80,000 that they earned. So from the $80,000 that they earned, they will reduce their taxable income to $69,000, and then they will pay, they will get a refund of $1,320. I mean, it's a still tax saving. It's still a cash flow that you receive right away. However, if they don't do this, but do the Roth IRA, and let's say invest this money for the illustration purposes, they put the $11,000 for 5 years, making 7% interest, then doing absolutely nothing at all and not contributing anything else to this $11,000, then in 5 years, they will have $15,593.88 absolutely tax-free. If they keep this money for another 10 years, then they're gonna have $22,106. And again, remember, this is absolutely tax-free. So if after 5 years, they decide to take the $11,000 out of this $15,000, they can freely do this. If it's a traditional IRA, they cannot do this because they're not 59 and a half yet. They will have to pay the 10% penalty. So this is the traditional IRA. Here, if they decide to take out the $11,000, which is the initial contribution, there's zero penalty and there's zero tax. Here, they have to pay 10% penalty, and then they will have to pay whatever tax bracket they are, whatever the percent, they will have to pay the tax. So let's say in 5 years, they're already not making $80,000, but they're making $180,000. So they will be already in a completely different tax bracket. I mean, we don't know what tax bracket's gonna be with all the changes that constantly going on, But let's assume they will be like in a 28% tax bracket. So if they want to take the 11,000, let's say they take the, so they will have to pay, it's like what, around $3,000 in taxes. So they saved before only $1,320, but now they have to pay much more. It's about over $3,000 plus the penalty. Versus here, the Roth IRA, they paid the $1,320. Now they're taking $11,000, they're paying zero penalty, they're paying zero tax, and then they still have another $5,593 to accumulate until all these years they still have to compound more interest that will be absolutely tax-free. So in these illustrations, I just want to show you that there is benefits in every case, in every scenario, in every plan. If it's a Roth IRA, if it's a traditional, if it's a traditional 401k, or if it's a Roth 401k. So what needs to be done is just everything needs to be planned ahead. And it needs to be planned it needs to be planned every year. At least what I advise to my clients, at least twice a year, in the beginning and then in the end. So in the beginning, when the year starts, you already know how much you're making, and then you want to plan how much you should be contributing, how much can you contribute, so then you start planning and estimating and creating all the action steps for yourself. And then at the end of the year, as the situation changes every year, as we don't know, we might be working right now, we might may not be working tomorrow. We might be making today 100,000 and we might get a bonus in few months, or we might get a new job. So everything changes throughout the year. So before the year ends, it's advisable to come and then to start calculating and going over all the numbers and then see what can be done. Many clients, and I see this all the time, they come after the year ends when it's the tax season, when it's time to do the tax returns. But actually, it's wrong. You don't plan when it's time to do the tax return. You plan in advance for another year, but for the past year, everything needs to be done in advance. So as you can see from this presentation, just to sum everything up, so I talked to you about the benefits of the traditional IRA, the benefits of the Roth IRA, the same thing as the 401k and then Roth 401k, the difference between the traditional and the Roth IRA, the difference between the traditional 401k and the Roth 401k, the benefits of the pension plans, and then the benefits of the tax planning, the benefits of the strategic planning, and then how to start accumulating tax-free income, how to have the tax-free income, how to save money on taxes, how to pay less taxes. So we covered all of this. We covered a lot of subjects, and I hope that you find this very helpful. I hope that now it's more clear for you. And if there is more questions, then please send it to us. If you like to schedule an appointment for the tax planning, you're welcome to do so. You can message us, you can email us. And I think that will conclude our session. Thank you so much for being with us. And remember, the financial freedom is all in your hands. Thank you so much for watching.